Welcome. I am Professor Rajendra Salokhe. This is the second part of two-night defense. In the first part, we have seen that the moves which take place commonly are e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop c4, knight f6, two knights have come out, knight to g4, g5, d5, e cross d5, knight cross d5, knight cross f7, king cross f7, queen to f3, king to e6, protecting the knight. And now we had seen that we are making various parts depending upon the move of the knight at c6. So in the first part we studied knight to c3. From white is the obvious move again to threaten this knight on d5, but we have seen the move knight to b5, which is actually the best move. The second best is of course knight to d4, threatening the white queen, and we will see some games played in this variation. So we start the game e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop c4, knight f6, knight g5, d5, e cross d5, knight cross d5, knight cross f7, king cross f7, queen f3, king e6, knight c3, and now knight b4. Actually this is not the second best. Probably I said it's second best. Second best would be to take the knight here to e7 and defend the knight on d5. But now we proceed with this game. Next move for white is bishop cross d5, obviously. It takes the king to e7, queen to f7, and check. You have to remember this move. Sometimes you forget that you have to take the king to queen to f7 and give a check. King goes to d6 and knight to e4 and checkmate. This also you have to remember, that knight going to, because in one game this position occurred and I just forgot to take the knight to e4 and it checkmates. But I played something else that time. So one more example we see of this. This is e4, e5, knight f3, knight c6, bishop c4, knight f6, knight g5, d5, cross d5, knight cross d5, knight cross f7, king cross f7, queen f3, check, king e6, knight c3, and takes knight to d4. Here, why I have given this? Oh. Then obviously bishop cross d5, king goes to d6. Last time he moved the king to e7, so now he's moved to d6. So then white plays same thing, queen to f7, then takes knight cross to c2. Now this is dangerous. Actually you need lot of calculations, because you are allowing a force to fork to king and rook. So your rook is gone here. You have to move the king because there is a check by knight. So you move the king to d1. He takes the rook, knight cross a1, but there is a mate in 1 year. Again, the same thing, knight going to e4 is a checkmate. You have to always remember, like last time I said, knight going to e4 is a mate, checkmate. So thank you very much for watching. We'll be having one more part of this, where, as I said, the knight moves to e7, and there is one more move, but already I made a video in English on that. I'll just give link for that video, and please subscribe if you're not subscribed.